Namashivaya, I'm Sanchita Roy. Welcome to Class 12's Biology class. Today's topic is Principles of Inheritance and Variation, Part 3. Today I'm going to discuss about the chromosomal theory of inheritance. In our previous video, I have already discussed about how the characters are transmitted from one generation to another. Mendel gave certain theories, and those theories were the law of dominance, law of segregation, and law of independent assortment. According to Mendel, he said that there are a pair of genes, and these genes are getting transmitted from one generation to another, and they are helping in transferring the characters from one generation to another. According to chromosomal theory of inheritance, it says that chromosome as well as gene both occurs in pair. It says that inside the human body, the cells are containing the chromosomes, and the chromosomes are in a paired condition the way the genes are paired together. The two alleles of a gene pair are located on the same locus on the homologous chromosomes. That means on the same homologous chromosomes in the same place. For example, capital T, capital T. If both are supposed to be there, they are supposed to be located in the same locus, that is in the same place. Not capital T here and the small t here or capital T here. In both the homologous chromosomes, they will be sharing the same locus, that means same site where both the genes of a particular character are located. Sutton and Boveri argued that the pairing and separation of a pair of chromosomes would lead to segregation of a pair of factors they carried. The way Mendel said that during the time of gamete formation, the genes get segregated randomly. Similarly, Sutton and Boveri also said that during the time of gamete formation, the chromosomes get segregated, will get separated, and they will get transformed into the gametes. Sutton united the knowledge of chromosomal segregation with the Mendelian principles and called it the chromosomal theory of inheritance. He added with Mendel that as the genes are getting transferred, they are getting randomly segregated during the time of gamete formation. Similarly, Sutton and Boveri, they said that during the time of gamete formation, these chromosomes will get separated, and these sister chromatids, what they will do? They will get transferred into the different gametes. The next is what the theory, the chromosomal theory of inheritance, as I have just discussed. Over here, there is an example. Over here, in an organism with the four chromosomes, that there are four chromosomes. These from four chromosomes in the G1 phase will be followed by the S phase, that is a synthesis phase. We know that the interphase is having the cell cycle. The interphase is having three phases, that is the G1 phase, then the S phase where the replication is taking place, that is the number of chromosome will get doubled over here. And in the G2 phase, what is going to happen after the G2 phase? The meiosis 1 will begin. In the meiosis 1, we will see that the chromosomes in the anaphase, the homologous chromosomes are getting segregated. And in the meiosis 2 anaphase, we will see that they are further getting divided into two daughter cells. So from a single cell, we are getting four daughter cells. So in this way, the four gametes will be produced, and the gametes are going to transfer the characters from the parent to the offsprings. So there are certain similarities between the chromosomes and the genes. What are the similarities? Each diploid cell has two sets of chromosome. Similarly, each diploid cell has two copies of a gene, because we have seen that the genes are located on the chromosome. When there is a two chromosome, then automatically the genes will also be present in two copies. A gamete contains half number of chromosomes than the somatic cells. That means over here the somatic cell is having four. What will the gamete have? The gamete will have single number, because the another number is going to come from the other another parent in the sexual mode of reproduction, what is going to happen? This gamete from two chromosome numbers, from 2 and it will become the 4. Okay, so what is going to happen? The gamete contains half the number of the chromosome than the somatic cell. A gamete also contains half the number of genes than the somatic cells. Each member of homologous pair of chromosome assorts independently during meiosis. They are not linked together. They are not going to that always. It is not going to happen that this and this is going to go together. They can randomly go with each another. Two or more genes assort independently. This has been proved by Mendel, where we have got the different types of recombinants. Because we got, when we did the dihybrid cross, when we have discussed about the seed shape and the seed color over there, we have seen that two new recombinant varieties are arising. From there, Mendel gave us that the law of independent assortment, and so from there we say that two or more genes assort independently. They get segregated independently. Chromosomes show segregation during meiosis. Genes also segregate during meiosis. Chromosomes duplicate during meiosis. Genes also duplicate during meiosis, because over here the genes are present on these chromosomes. The way the chromosome is getting duplicated, similarly the genes are also getting duplicated. So these are the similarities. Chromosomes mutate, that means changes can occur in the chromosome. In the chromosome, where the change will take place? The change will take place in the genes. Genes also get mutated. So these are the similarities between the chromosome and the genes. Then what is the dissimilarity? Chromosomes are visible under the microscope. Genes are not visible under the microscope. Chromosomes are composed of DNA, histones and RNA, whereas genes are composed of either DNA or RNA. Next, we will discuss about linkage and recombination. So far, we have discussed about how the inheritance is taking place. This linkage and recombination was worked by Morgan. Morgan was a zoologist and he was awarded the Nobel Prize in the year 1933 in the field of medicine for his contribution in genetics. He worked on a Drosophila, a fruit fly. This Drosophila is, we can see, commonly hovering over the fruits. They are easily available and they are having some alleles are carried only on one of the sex chromosomes. And Thomas Hunt Morgan discovered Drosophila's eye color are carried only on the female chromosome, that is the X chromosome. And this is as called as sex-linked characteristic. As with other genetic traits, the outcome of breeding can be predicted. Why did he select the Drosophila? It is a very common question which comes in the board examination. What is there? Because of its small size. It is having a short generation time of 10 days, and in a normal room temperature they can grow. Each female lays 400 to 500 eggs. So what is there? The number of offsprings produced is a huge. So if the number of offsprings are more, then the study can be done in a better way. Easy to culture in laboratory. It can easily grown in the laboratory. They are having a small genome. They are having only 4 pairs of genes. That is 3 pairs of autosomes and 1 pair of sex chromosome. And their sex chromosome is usually XY type, like the human beings. They are having large chromosomes. Many mutations are available. As they are having different types of mutations, so it can be studied very clearly. Now, what is there? You can see how the life cycle is. The male and the female are very distinctively, they can be identified with our naked eyes. The male are usually smaller compared to the female flies. as well, the way the pea plant is having contrasting characters, they also shows different type of contrasting characters. Like over here, you can see the red eyes. In the normal wild condition, the Drosophilas are having red colored eyes. But in some of the cases, due to the mutation, some of the Drosophilas can have white colored eyes. Over here, you can see they are white colored eyes. So in this way, they can study easily about how the transmission of characters are taking place from one generation to another. So within 10 days, they can complete their life cycle. So because of these advantages, Drosophila was utilized by Dr. Morgan for working in his laboratory, and he gave us the different types of results. So what do we come to know from Morgan's work? Morgan said about the linkage and recombination. What does this linkage and recombination means? He conducted different experiments on the Drosophila, and he considered a dihybrid cross. In a dihybrid cross, we know that we will consider about two characters. That means two genes are involved. So he said that when the two genes are situated on the same chromosome, then according to Morgan, the proportion of the parental gene combination was much higher than the non-parental type. According to Mendel, he said that in a dihybrid cross, what is the ratio? The ratio in the F2 generation is 9:3:3:1. But Morgan found that when the genes are located on the same chromosome, then in the F2 generation, the percentage of the recombinants is far less compared to the parental type. Now let us understand what does it mean. He conducted two experiments, cross A, cross B. In cross A, he considered about the body color and the eye color of the insect. He took the eye color, body color and the eye color, they are linked, they are sex linked characters. That means they are found to be present in the sex chromosome. In the X chromosome, the body color and the eye color genes are located on the X chromosome. So he took one mutated form, that is a recessive trait. Insect is having, the female is having the yellow colored body and it is having a white eye, whereas the male is having the gray color body and it is having the red color eye. So we call it as a wild type. Now, what type of gametes will be produced by these two parents? In case of the female is going to produce a single kind of gamete because the females are homogametic. So small y, small w, two gametes are produced by the female. On the other hand, the male Drosophila is going to produce two types of gametes because they are heterogametic. They are going to produce one X chromosome, the other is the Y chromosome. So in the F1 generation, what we will get? We will get a wild type and a recessive type of male. As because the small y, small w, it is located on the X chromosome, so they will get expressed in the male. But what is happening over here, small y, small w is present. But as because this dominant character has come from the male, so the offspring will be of wild type. Now, over here, self-crossing is being done. The way we have done the dihybrid cross in Mendel's experiment, similarly, self-cross is being done over here. When the self-cross is being done over here, let us see what are the gametes produced by the female. First of all, the female will produce small y, small w. Over here, small y, small w. Then another will small y plus and w plus. Y plus, w plus. These are produced by the female. Now, the another probability is the crossing over can take place over here in between the homologous sister chromatids. So if the crossing over takes place over here, then what can happen? The chromosome can become YW plus and at the same time Y plus W. You can see Y plus W crossing over taking place over here, and similarly YW plus is coming over here. The male is going to produce two types of gamete. One is YW, that is the X chromosome. The other is the Y chromosome. So all of them, the Y chromosome is going to come over here. Because there cannot be any crossing over between the X chromosome and the Y chromosome. Crossing over can take place only between the sister chromosome, between the homologous chromosomes. Y and X are not homologous chromosomes. They are not similar, but they lie together in case of the males. In F2 generation, the another one, what is going to happen? Another gamete, this gamete is going to come from the father. So what is going to happen? The same way the gametes are present, the female is producing four gametes. We have just seen over there, the same female gametes are present over here. And the another Y and W gametes are coming from the male, and over here the offsprings are produced. Now, when the calculation is done over here, it has been seen that the parental varieties is comprising of 98.7%, whereas the recombinant variety is only 1.3%. On the other hand, let us study cross B. In cross B, what we can see over there, he considered eye color and the size of the wing, that is a miniature. This wing size is also located on the X chromosome, but it is away, far away from the eye color gene. Okay, so their location is in a different place. They are located far away from each another. Same way he considered about the white color eye as well as the miniature wing. And over here it is a wild type, that is the red eye with a normal big wing. So over here the gamete produced over here in the F1 generation, we can find the wild type female and the white color eyed miniature wing male. Again over here self crossing is being done, but now what we can see is that the parental type which we are getting over here, the parental type is 62.8%, whereas the recombinant type is 37.2%. Why is it so? Over here what we can see, just the way we have seen over here, what are the gametes produced by the female? The female is producing WM, W plus M plus, W plus M plus WM. Over here crossing over will take place. Now over here what will happen? W plus M and WM plus, WM plus. The male Y chromosome comes from the father. Similarly, the same female gametes are present over here and the X chromosome comes down from the father. So over here, what was found? The number of recombinants produced in the F2 generation was far more. What did Morgan said? Morgan says that when we are considering two genes which are located in the same chromosome, they tend to go together from one generation to another. What I said? They tend to go from one generation to another together. Over here, the number of recombinants, that is the probability of crossing over, is very less. So the number of recombinant varieties are also lesser. The Morgan attributed this due to the physical association or the linkage of the two genes, and coined the linkage to describe the physical association of the genes on same chromosome. The generation of non-parental gene combination during dihybrid cross is called recombination. That is, the things which were not present in the parental generation but we can find it in the offspring, they are called recombinants. When genes are located on same chromosome, they are tightly linked and show very little recombination. But why did we get the different recombinants in case of Mendel's work? We got it because the characters considered by Mendel were located in different chromosomes, not on the same chromosomes like what we are seeing over here in case of the Drosophila. So over here, you are just going to see it once more. Over here, as we were discussing about the white eyes winged and the wild type of male, over here we can see how the recombinations are
produced over here. The total parental type is approximately 1541 offsprings, and the total recombinant is 900. So what is happening? The percentage of recombinations is over here quite high. The number of recombinants are quite higher in this case. Why? We have just discussed about the W and M, that is the white eye color and the miniature wings, which we have discussed in the previous slide. So over here the recombinants are huge, so the percentage came over here 36.9. as because the genes were located in a faraway place, so what happened, the probability of crossing over was more, so the recombinant phenotypes has come more higher. Whereas when we are talking about the characters which are close by, what is going to happen, the rate of recombinant is becoming very less. The percentage of recombinant over here you can see is becoming very less. So this is how all about the recombination and linkage. So what is the difference between the crossing over and linkage? It leads to separation of linked genes. That means the genes which are linked together, which are placed side by side, what is going to happen? The crossing over will take place, and which will lead to the separation of the characters. So over here you can see the crossing over has taken place, and that is the reason B plus and VG has come. Two things are getting joined over here. This is called the crossing over. But in case of linkage, what is going to happen? It keeps the genes together. The genes are kept together. The genes are passing capital B plus and VG plus. They are going together. So over here, in case of linkage, they will pass on together. Whereas in crossing over, two varieties are getting mixed up together. It involves non-sister chromatids of the homologous chromosomes. It involves individual chromosomes. In linkage, it is talking about the individual chromosome. In crossing over, it is talking about non-sister homologous chromosomes. They are not sister. This is a sister and this is a non-sister. Frequency of crossing over can never exceed 50%. Linkage groups can never be more than haploid chromosome numbers. It increases variability by forming new gene combination, because they are crossing over is taking place, so new variety is developing. In case of linkage, it reduces variability because the same genes are getting transferred from the parent to the offspring. So the variability, the variation is becoming negligible. It provides equal frequency of parental and recombinant types in test cross progeny, provides higher frequency of parental types than recombinant types in a test cross progeny. When we perform the test cross, we find that the parental varieties are more compared to the recombinant types. So over here we will complete today. We will be discussing the next part of the chapter about the sex determination in the next video. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.